Hello, my creative friends. This is Heather North from heatherscreativeblessings.com. I've been busy working on World Card Making Day cards. We're going to have a big celebration over at Stamp Nation. And this card is actually inspired by one of those photos. This card isn't for Stamp Nation, though. It's for all of you. I use Stampin' Up's Bloom with Hope stamp set, and I'm going to use some Memento. I thought this was Tuxedo Black ink, but it's actually London Fog. It's a really pretty gray. I'm going to stamp it a couple of times in different locations, and then I'll color it in, and I'll end up cutting it out. You'll see the second time I stamp it, I move it down just a little bit so that the placement doesn't look like it's exactly the same. I decided to stamp that little list flower one more time so that I could fussy cut it out and pop it up later on my card. Here you'll see, if you look at the bottom of the screen, the bottom right, I've got a paper pack, and that's how I'm choosing my Copic colors. I am not a Copic coloring expert, I'm kind of a beginner, and I'm still a little, I don't know, unsure of my colors, so I also like to test them out. I've got some Copic Expressit paper here, that's what I've stamped on, and you'll see me using these colors and kind of blending them together, see if I like the way they look, because they don't always look the same as the lid, and see if they match the paper pack I'm going to use. This is going to be a very quick coloring. I started with my lightest color, RB04, and did an all-over color wash on my flower. Then I'm going to come into the center with RB06, and I'm just going to add some deep shadow into the center. And then I come in with my darkest color, and that is RB09. And I just, as you see, added even darker shadows. I followed the lines of the stamp. And then I took my lightest color again, the RV04, and just did an all-over wash to kind of blend the colors. From here, I decided to do the rest of these flowers all together. So I took my lightest color. Again, it's that RV04. I put down a wash of color on the biggest flower, the little bud, and some of these petals. I'm only going to cut some of them out. Then I'm coming in with my medium color, and again adding shadows from the center out. And finally, I'm going to add in my darkest shade. And I'm doing flicking lines from the center of my flower to the outside of my flowers. And I've got my lightest color, and I'm going to do an all-over wash again. I'm just going to repeat this process for the smallest flower and continue to blend until I get the soft lines that I want and the deep shadows as well. The die cut I'm going to use is called Embellished Tag. It's from Mama Elephant. And what I'm doing there is I'm just seeing where I'm going to end up cutting the shape out and making sure that all of the flowers that will be showing are colored in. And then I'll move on to the stems and the leaves. Starting with G24, just lay down a little bit of green, and then I'm going to come back in with my darker shades of green to add some shadows and creases and lines into the leaves and stems. There's a not very much area for shading and blending, so what I do is after I add those darker colors, I just come in with my lighter color and sort of blend it out. The center of my flower is going to be colored with Y11 and Y08. The Y11 is actually a little bit lighter color, so I lay that down first, and then I just touch one side of the center of the flower with that Y08. I'm going to fussy cut out the small flower, and I find it easier just to take a big chunk all the way around it, and then I'm going to come in and do that fine detail, trying to move the flower more than I do my scissors. And after I have it cut out, just to make sure that there's no white edge showing, I'm going to come back with my Copics and go around the outside edge. I first tried the lightest color, and that is RV04. Then I decided I wanted more of a shadow, so I came back in with my darker color and did a darker shadow, just barely touching into the creases and around some of the areas with that RV09. I'm going to use my magnetic platform to cut this out. So it's a magnetic platform, a cutting plate, that embellished tag for Mama Elephant. I'm just going to line it up exactly where I want it to cut. And then I'm going to put another clear plate on top and run it through my Big Shot. The sentiment I'm going to be using is Happy Birthday, since it's Marla's birthday. Again, it's from the Stampin' Up! Hostess set, Bloom with Hope. I'm using VersaFine Black Onyx ink. It's a really nice dark black ink, but it takes a long time to dry, and if I leave it to dry, I usually end up smearing it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take some clear embossing powder from Stampin' Up, and I'm going to sprinkle it over my tag, and then I'm going to heat emboss it to set it, and that way I don't have to worry about smearing, but it also gives the sentiment a little bit of shine. Now I'm going to pull all these elements together and see if I end up liking the final product. My card base is Smoky Slate, and then the paperback I'm using is called Flourish from Authentique. And I've got a 1.5 inch strip right there of the pink, and then a 4 by 5.25 inch piece of that background butterfly script paper. I'm just going to line up my 1.5 inch strip on the left side, and I'm going to use my scissors to trim off the top, and then I'm going to layer this on a piece of Lost Lagoon cardstock that's just a 1/4 inch bigger, or actually it's only 1/8 inch bigger, so it's 4 1/8 by 5 3/8, and again I use my snail adhesive to adhere that down. I like to use lots of extra snail just to make sure it doesn't come off when it gets mailed or just over time. I center that paper as best I can and adhere it to my card base. And then I'm going to take a piece of silver ribbon. I make bunny ears, wrap them around each other to make a bow. I just love the sparkle and shimmer and shine in this ribbon that Stampin' Up's come out with. To give my card dimension, I'm just going to take Stampin' Up! Dimensionals. I like to use more than you need just to stick it to your card, because I like to make sure that I have even dimension all the way around. And I was testing it out and added just one more to make sure that when the card is finished that you don't have little dips and valleys in the tag. I'm going to use another dimensional on the back of my flower that I fussy cut, and just adhere that to the tag, gives it just a little bit of pop. And then I'm going to take a mini glue dot, I'm going to roll it around in my finger, and it makes a little ball, stick it on the back of my bow, and then put the bow right on my tag. I'll just do a quick trim of the tails of my bow, and then I'm going to pull out some sequins. I've been adding sequins to just about every card lately. These are from Pretty Pink Posh, and they are the Sparkling Clear 4mm, so they're really tiny. They add just a nice little bit of sparkle, I guess, to any card. I do love them. And when I use them with flowers especially, they just remind me of little dewdrops. I took some Studio Matte Medium. It's a glue that dries matte and clear, so you don't see that shiny residue of glue once it dries if it pokes out onto the paper. And I just put a little bit on my finger, and then I put it onto the back of the sequin and add it to my card. I had this leftover frame that I cut out of the same authentic paper and decided, oh, this might be a good thing to put on the inside of my card. So I took the, it's called Special Wishes stamp set from Penny Black, and I used the same London Fog Memento ink and just stamped my sentiment onto that framelit die cut. And then I just added the last two little sparkling clear sequins that were laying on my table. I'll add this framelit to the inside of my card, and the card will be done. Hopefully this has piqued your interest a little bit in the inspiration that's coming to Stamp Nation for World Card Making Day next weekend, October 4th. I hope that you find some time today to get a little bit creative and maybe even color. Thank you for joining me. Bye.